All right, Shalom Akiam, Shalom Israel. This is the brother Awaraba, Great Millstone Dallas, coming back at you again with another lesson. Before I get started, I'm going to go ahead and give all glory, honor, and praise to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakal Kadash. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone who rule well. Peace and salutations to the hopeful and humble elect that's out there kicking this truth and sincerity across the four corners of the planet Earth, helping to elect or erect the house of David and to help defeat spiritual wickedness in all different places. All right. Shalom to you, sincere Akwath and Akwathium that are out there. Subscribe to the channel that are also here tuning in as we do this thing. All right. So today's topic, the reason that I'm making this video is because I want to focus more or less on just the time that we're in, and this is actually, as you see on the screen, the winter solstice. All right, we're in those times and in that time frame where there's a lot of spiritual demonic energy, man, that's going out and that's getting pushed upon us whether we like it or not. Okay, and so I want, you know, those of us that are in this faith to be mindful of keeping yourself cleansed, spiritually cleansed, keeping your temple cleansed and free of negative energy, man. Okay? Because we got to remember, this is a spiritual fight, brothers. Okay? This ain't just, you know, one thing that's on us. You know, the Most High has given us the tools, the knowledge, wisdom, and understanding to be able to ward off these such things, man. And there's different things that you can use to cleanse yourself as well. But we'll get into it as the lesson goes on, Lord willing. Okay? So the first thing that I wanted to talk about, like I said before I get this precept, is this winter solstice situation. And there's a lot of rituals and paganistic rituals that take place that not only do the elites do it, but also, you know, the people that the practitioners that are on the left hand side that deal with a lot of that sorcery and other demonic deities. Okay, and there's a lot of different ones that go on throughout this time of year. Okay, of course, you know, you got Saturnalia that took place. You have, of course, so-called Christmas. And then you have a lot of other ones, like this particular one in reference right here. This is called Yule. Okay, now this particular one, Yule or Yuletide, Yule season, is a festival historically observed by the Germanic people. Okay, that's a branch of Esau. Okay, or a branch of E. All right. Scholars have connected the original celebrations of Yule to the wild hunt, the god Odin. See, as you see, these pagan gods and the pagan Anglo-Saxon Mandranicht, which Mandranicht in the German basically means mother of, yeah, right there. Okay, the mother, night of the mothers. Or mother's nights. Okay, so you can already see that these guys are there. They were ramping up and demonically energized, and are pushing these things out there upon the earth, man. These negative vibrations. Okay, I'm gonna continue and get a little bit more on this before I get into my precept. Okay, it says, Mandranicht. Well, actually, I'm gonna drop back. I'm gonna get out of that one. But I'll read a little bit. It was an event held at what is now Christmas Eve by the Anglo-Saxon pagans. This event is attested by the medieval English historian Bede in his 80th century Latin work, De Temporum Rationale. Okay, basically, you know, you drop down, it's a female deity that they worship, okay, during this time that they bear homage to. And so the thing with these witches, man, and these warlocks and these wizards, they have to use the power of some type of deity or some type of spirit to do their work, to do their bidding, you know, and then they cast upon and that's what these elites do too, okay? These elite families are doing this religiously all the time, all right? Especially during this time of the year. So back to my lesson, I just wanted to say it's very, you know, it's very important that you continue to keep yourself armored up so that you can stand against these things, man. All right. Okay. This is Ephesians chapter 6, and I'm going to start at 11. And it says, put on the whole armor of the Most High, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, and against spiritual wickedness in high places. Yeah, just like I said earlier, you got to remember, this is a definitely spiritual battle that we're in right now. Okay? And it's just as we have a right-hand side power and powers underneath, the left-hand side, they have theirs too. Okay? And they're not taking no breaks. They're not letting up. All right? Verse 13, it says, wherefore take unto you the whole armor of the Most High, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, having done all to stand. That's right, man. Fighting, man. You know what I'm saying? Fasting, praying, you know, etc. And also during this time, man, limiting the bullshit intake. You know what I mean? Things that you're watching, things that you're taking into your spirit. You know? Social media things, negative media stuff that you're watching on YouTube or on television, or things that you hear on the radio, certain types of music, all those types of things that create a negative energy or a negative vibe, man, that can cause a negative spirit or a demon to attach itself to you, you know? So you want to make sure that you limit all those types of, shut all those types of spiritual doors to your temple, man, okay? And feed it with good things. Cleanse yourself, you know, spiritually and physically. All right, there's several different types of cleansing things that you can do to cleanse yourself spiritually, man. You know, you got sage, you got a lot of other brothers that like to use Palo Santo, and a lot of different other ones, you know. And there's so many of them that you can choose from, but I'm going to leave that for you to look up in your own time. All right, but yeah, all these things affect your spirit, okay. I'm going to go back up here into 12 just to kind of prove that this is not a game, man. You know, there are celestial beings, okay? And there are demons, there are angels, there are things like that, man, that are out there, okay? I'm going to get this in the blue letter in Ephesians. This word principalities, okay? Oh, stand by. Bear with me, brothers. Principalities, it's G Strong 746.
Strong's G 746. Arche.
All right. And basically, I'm going to drop down and it says the beginning or the origin, the person or the things or comments is the first person or thing in a series, the leader. Okay. But here's the point. You go down to the fifth definition of angels and demons. Okay? You see? And against powers, that word powers right there. I mean, for those of us that, you know, I'm just doing this just for the edification. All right?
Strong's G, 1849. Exousia.
Right, the power of authority, influence, and of right privilege. Okay, I'm going to drop down right here into under C, the second verse. One who possesses authority, a ruler, or human magistrate. But this is B, the leading and more powerful among created beings, superior to man, spiritual potentates. All right, so that just lets you know right there what that's talking about, man. It's talking about demons, man. Things that you cannot beat without the help and power of Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. Okay, so protect yourselves at all costs, man. Protect your mind, protect your spirit. Okay, because all of this demonic time that we're going through, you know, it's gonna end. But the way that it ends, you know, it's gonna end in our favor, but you have to be able to be ready for it. You have to be prepared for it. There's things that you have to do through this fight. You can't just cruise and coast your way through this. All right. Okay, I'm gonna read 13 again. This is Ephesians 6 and 13 says, "Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of the Most High, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, having done all to stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girded about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace." All right, so, you know, and it goes on. But yeah, you know, the biblical Edomite and the Chaldeans were the main people that were known for doing a lot of this spiritual wickedness, man, that was out there doing all of these different types of hexes and using sorcery and witchcraft and all those types of things, man. And there's nothing's changed still to this day. In fact, they're just going a lot harder. All right, but there's a remedy coming for that. And I'm going to close with this. And this is going to be Isaiah. Where are you, Isaiah? Bear with me. Where art thou? Boom. Okay. Isaiah 47. I'll just get to the point. Okay. I'll start at 9. It says, "But these two things shall come to thee in a moment, in one day, the loss of children and widowhood. They shall come upon thee in their perfection, for the multitude of thy sorceries and for the great abundance of thine enchantments." All right, and this is going straight in on Babylon, man. This is talking directly to the rulers that are the powers that be here in spiritual Babylon in America, man. Okay, there is a recompense coming. All right, "For thou hast trusted in thy wickedness," and you see that week in and week out. You know, they're trusting in their philosophies, they're trusting in their sorceries, they're trusting in these other gods, these deities, these idols. Okay, "Thou hast said, none seeth me," because they like to hide in plain sight and act like ain't nothing wrong. "Thy wisdom and thy knowledge, it hath perverted thee, and thou hast said in thine heart, I am, and none else besides me," acting like you're the Most High. "Therefore shall evil come upon thee, thou shalt not know from whence it riseth, and mischief shall fall upon thee. Thou shalt not be able to put it off, and desolation shall come upon thee suddenly, which thou shalt not know." That's right. The Lord said he's going to come like a thief in the night, man. Okay. "Stand now with thine enchantments and with the multitudes of thy sorceries, and wherein thou hast labored from thy youth. So if so be, thou shalt be able to profit. If so, thou mayest prevail." And we already know that they're not going to be able to prevail, man. They're not going to be able to prevail because it was written. It was written how their end was going to be. Okay, that's how they were took out then. It's going to be how they were taken out now. "Thou art," verse 13, "thou art wearied in the multitude of thy counsels. Let now the astrologers, the stargazers, the monthly prognosticators stand up." And these are all different types of witchcraft, man. All different types of sorcery, magic that they do, from astrology, you know, people that think they can tell things through the stars, monthly prognosticators, people that think that they can foretell or predict things that are coming within the future monthly, you know. Verse 4, "Behold, they shall be as stubble," all right, "the fire shall burn them, they shall not deliver themselves from the power of the flame." That's right, man. You see? So even though you're out there throwing up all these hexes and doing all types of wickedness, man, live it up. And this is, you know, this is talking to two-thirds of Jake as well, because these guys are also in league with E and his and his rituals and dealings. Okay? So there's a big hefty price to pay for those people that are doing these enchantments and things of that nature. All right? But not to digress, just remember to protect yourself, protect your neck, protect your spirit while going through these times, and modify or moderately take in things that you can refrain from negativity, man. Stay away from negative vibes, negative energy. Okay? And so with that, I hope that this lesson's been edifying. Before I get out, I'm going to give all praise, glory, and honor to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahawashah, Bahashem, Rakakwadash. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone who rule well. Peace and salutations to the hopeful elect. Shalom.